success rate and completion rate. The distinction between these two metrics often causes confusion. They sound extremely similar and seem to describe the same thing. But there are crucial differences in how we measure them and what limitations they have. To make this distinction clear, let's start with their definitions. Completion rate refers to the percentage of individuals who complete a business goal or a process they initiated. Success rate is the percentage of individuals who successfully complete a task. To calculate completion rate, we use analytics tools such as Google Analytics. When we use these tools, we don't have a precise understanding of our users' goals. We can only see how they behave when they interact with our product, but we don't know why they came to our page in the first place. Because of this limitation, we can use analytics tools to measure if users successfully completed a task only when the user's intentions are obvious. This is a case when users go through a linear process with a fixed number of steps. For example, the checkout flow of an e-commerce website. There, you must enter your name and address, your credit card information, choose your preferred shipping method, and then you order your item. A linear flow with a fixed number of steps. In such cases, we can precisely measure how many users started and finished the process. However, when it comes to situations where our users' intentions are not obvious, using analytics tools is not helpful. Because without knowing our users' specific goal, we can't assess if they were able or unable to accomplish it. So when there are tasks with multiple pathways to accomplish them, like finding a specific article on a website, we can't use analytics, which gives us a completion rate, but we must use usability testing, which gives us a success rate. By using usability testing, we know our users' goals because we provide them with a task and a specific goal. In this scenario, we know exactly what the user wants to accomplish. And to measure if they were successful in doing so, it doesn't matter which path they took. So when we measure the success rate of finding a specific article on our website, it doesn't matter which path our users are taking. For example, they could use the main navigation or the search feature of the page. Either way, we can measure if they are successful in finding the article or not. In other words, we know the goal, so the process to get there doesn't matter. To summarize, both of these metrics measure if our users are able to successfully accomplish a task or process. However, we get these two metrics from different research methods, which have different limitations. To measure completion rate, we use analytics tools. Using these tools, we are lacking an understanding of our users' goals. So they are best suited to capture if users can complete linear, step-by-step processes, because there the users' goals are obvious. Success rate is measured within a usability test, which gives us a precise understanding of the user's goals. This allows us to measure success for tasks that are more flexible and can be accomplished in multiple ways.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.